Do you hear what I hear? Before the prancing and pawing of each little hoof of Santa's 8 tiny reindeer will be heard on the roof, there's a joyful sound that denotes the coming of the Yuletide season in just a few instantly recognizable notes. Of course, I am talking about Mariah Carey's All I Want for Christmas Is You. While it's become a holiday classic, the song is taking on a whole new meaning this season. If, like Mariah, you don't want a lot for Christmas and don't care about the presents underneath the Christmas tree, this may be your year. That's because Bidenomics is causing everything to be backordered, delayed, unavailable, or just plain unaffordable. Even Christmas trees are in short supply. So don't be surprised if your only option to deck the halls this year looks like Charlie Brown's sad little twig of a fir tree branch. Whether shopping at a store or online, we are all experiencing it. With the cost of gifts up 20% and consumer prices surging to the highest level in over 30 years, you are paying a whole lot more for a whole lot less. That is, if you can even find what you are looking for. Perhaps the most telling sign of the times, the Dollar Tree, which had to discontinue selling some of its popular products due to cost constraints, is raising prices to $1.25. President Biden's contribution to this year's season of giving could best be summed up by an elf on an empty shelf. After all, the Biden administration has ignored, dismissed, and even contributed to the conditions causing these economic hardships. Speaking at the White House just last week, the president actually claimed his efforts have resulted in, quote, shelves across the country being well stocked, end quote. That may be true at his White House gift shop, but not in the stores in Iowa and across the country. The supply chain problem is such a mess, not even Rudolph with his nose so bright can guide all of the barges stuck at sea into port by Christmas night. The Democrats' out-of-control spending spree and misguided economic policies, like paying people not to work for most of the year, have decreased both the availability of goods as well as the value of the money in your wallet. For folks in Iowa and the rest of the nation who are working longer hours due to labor shortages or just to keep up with the skyrocketing prices, this has created a real-life nightmare before Christmas. As a result, a record number of Americans say they won't be buying gifts this year. But rather than addressing these concerns, bare shelves Biden is pushing his so-called Build Back Better Act, which itself is a Christmas tree bill adorned with something for every left-wing special interest group and topped off with a massive $300 billion tax break for coastal elites. For those millionaires on their wish list who literally have everything, DC Democrats are wrapping up a generous tax cut worth nearly $17,000. To no one's surprise, those benefiting the most from this tax giveaway live in or around the San Francisco Congressional District, represented by Speaker Nancy Pelosi, and the state of New York, home of the Senate Majority Leader. It's a lot like a plot twist to Charles Dickens' classic, A Christmas Carol. But instead of learning to embrace the giving spirit of Christmas, Scrooge receives a tax handout paid for out of the pockets of essential workers struggling to provide for their own families. What a bunch of humbug. Santa Claus, I don't know if you are listening, but if you are, when you're making your list and checking it twice, remember that President Biden promised taxpayers that his Build Back Better plan costs $0, doesn't waste any money on tax breaks for the wealthy, and adds, you guessed it, $0 to the national debt. To no one's surprise, that promise ended up being a fa-la-la-la lot of malarkey. The truth is, the Biden bill costs $1.7 trillion, adds $367 billion to our debt, and gives a huge tax cut to millionaires. While the president certainly deserves a stocking full of coal for breaking his promises to taxpayers, even coal is in short supply at the moment, and the price has soared to the highest level in more than 12 years. Other energy prices, whether to warm your home or fill up the gas tank of your car, are also up sharply. The president has done his part to limit fuel supplies by signing executive orders to further restrict access to oil and gas. After enduring nearly 2 years of making sacrifices, folks should not have to now choose between heating their house, buying food for their families, or putting gifts under the tree. So rather than passing another one of President Biden's budget-busting bills, the best gift that Washington can give taxpayers is to keep this from being a blue Christmas and simply stop making matters worse. Folks who have worked hard all year desperately deserve a break from the economic pressures being caused by Bidenomics so they can enjoy some time with their families. And unlike last Christmas, we can once again rediscover the true meaning of this holiday season by spending time with those we love the most. Just like Mariah sings about, make my wish come true, all I want for Christmas is you. Madam President, I yield the floor.
Madam President.